for a year or two. They want him to produce right away.
That's why they took him in the first round. They expect him to be a starter right away and a future All-Pro. So they don't have any time to wait for him to come along. They want him to play right now to help this team.
And you take a look at this draft class from a season ago. Really, it grades out as a pretty darn good class.
So you have to give a lot of credit to the entire scouting organization. General manager, personnel department, college scouts all came together. They evaluated it very well and got a nice payoff.
He'll get this to his speedster, Paul Richardson. 12 yards is the pickup, and it's good for a Washington first down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Out of the gun, Keenum. Complete. Richardson has it. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The Redskins have the first down on a pickup of 18.
One of the selling points at the end route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver, and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball to the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
Looks like he's going to get a couple here on this first down carry, and that'll make it second and 8. Give the tackle there to Morgan Burnett.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. Working from the gun, Keenum. Catch made here by Campbell. And he's going to be taken down at the 39, clearly short of the first by a few yards. Defense. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march off another 15 against your squad.
On the run, it's Campbell. And able to work his way down to the 16. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. On 2nd down now, it's Campbell. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. And I think he's a guy, if they had let him walk, no one was going to be shouting from the top of a mountain. But he's a good guy. He's a good locker room guy, too.
Good locker room and a good player. I mean,
and he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Taking it in from 11 yards out. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they?
Once you're ready, go ahead and select Advance Week to get to your next game. Start your week by installing your game plan. This is the player card. Here, this is your development trait. Superstar. Start your week by installing your game plan. season by selecting your season goal.
It's the coach. This is the NFL.
They'll run on first down. Campbell. And this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. Up to make the stop, the Pro Bowl safety, Malcolm Jenkins. And as a first-rounder, a lot of eyes on him, a lot of expectations.
And he has to play well in his rookie year. Those days of cobbling guys and bringing them along slowly, those days are long gone. When you're drafted in the first round, they expect you to play right away. In the community's eyes and fan base, they'll be on you the entire way.
They added a lot of talent to a roster that really needed an infusion of youth. They got a very good infusion of youth.
And they didn't really reach to get anyone as well. They stuck to their draft philosophy, got the best players they could at the time they were drafting, and inserted them into their lineup.
The Redskins have the first down on a pickup of 18. On first down, Campbell. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line, tackled there. It'll go as a pickup of 14 and a Washington first down. So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
This carry with the extra effort is going to get him stopped up just shy of the 10. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. On 2nd down, it's Campbell. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And that'll get him halfway there as he takes it from the 6 to the 3-yard line. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. And they tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. A great play there with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive.
As we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. On 3rd down, it's Campbell. Pushes him over. He'll have a 1st down past the 40. takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. A big play there. Making quite a splash with his second touchdown in his NFL debut. And the Redskins are able to stretch the lead out further. And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And partner, you know exactly what.
This one gets him to the 10-yard line. The ground, and that'll make it second and four. On second down now, it's Campbell. And he's dropped just shy of the 25 at the 24. It'll go as a pickup of 14 and a Washington first down.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over a buck 50 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
The lane opens up that time as he'll be brought down just short of a first after a gain of about 9. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and one. They'll run with the big man, Campbell. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Give him 16 yards there, and it's a Redskin first down. We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. A run there on first down and a pretty good one of 5 yards, so make it second and five. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. A gain there of 21 yards.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. They run on first down as they get about 3. Second and 7 forthcoming. A gain of 3. Second down. On second down, it's Campbell. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he's all the way down to the 6-yard line. 16 yards, a first down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. A great effort there. Now with his third touchdown in his first ever NFL game. And the Redskins are able to stretch the lead out further.
I heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially one.
Yardage, not that it matters, as the final seconds tick away. So, all right, we will. They'll run on first down. Campbell, and he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5. Now this matchup, an important one for week one, an NFC East bout right off the bat. These two teams have met twice a year since 1936. 168 meetings overall, and the Redskins lead the series, but the Eagles, they have won 4 straight against these Washington Redskins. They'll try and fight for it here with Campbell. Bulldozes past him, and he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. It's a first down for the Redskins on a pickup of 11.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Give him 16 yards there, and it's a Redskin first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. On first down, Campbell. And he'll get four here down to the 35-yard line.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old-school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Give the Redskins 13 there on a first down. They'll run on first down. It's Campbell. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
Here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Here's Campbell, and he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Redskins are able to stretch the lead out further. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know.
Tacked on for good measure. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
A first down run, not going to get him a whole lot. Maybe a yard. Yeah, it looks like just 1 yard there. So that'll bring up second and nine. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Redskin football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. On third down, it's Campbell. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. They'll run on first down. It's Campbell. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Derek Barnett able to maneuver in for the sack.
I think most quarterbacks would love to have the goal line actually extend up into the air and turn into a wall. And they could put their back against it and know exactly where they are on the field so they don't end up in the end zone. Didn't do it on that play, but perilously close to the goal line.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. On the handoff, here's Campbell. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15. So a victory here for the Washington Redskins. And with that, our journey begins, Charles. Week one in the books. Going to be a great season.
Oh, man, so much to look forward to. Isn't it nice to get a really good game right out of the gate? Preseason behind us. All these games count now, don't they?
Yeah, this is the exciting time with just 1 week gone and plenty of weeks to come. So for Washington, not much to complain about here.
Best song ever.
I've heard that.
And there's nothing better than the tiger raw, dude.
I gotta take a leak.
Tiger raw. Oh, it's called the tiger rag.
Don't you love it when your parents don't fuck with you, like, It's just a chill day.
I know. That's how my day's been today. My mom's like, you've been at home too much. She's like, you're going to town tomorrow. I'm like, I don't give a fuck. I ain't going to town.
Yeah.
Like, you can just fucking grind video games and, like, life is fun. My Wednesday went awful, bro. Fucking shitty. Dude, at 8 o'clock, I gotta freaking do some shit.
You gotta do what?
I gotta get Blitz Bolts on freaking Madden.
Okay,
I'm gonna go get a fucking taco right quick. Taco Villa is so mint.
I love Taco Bell like 10 times a day.
Taco Villa burritos are good though.
Taco Bell is better. I'll bet this will cover almost 28 yards. That's so freaking cage. Two dead and stabbing attack me in London Bridge. Oh my god. Okay, boomer. Okay, boomer. Block that, block that. Oh my gosh, blocked. I hate when, like,
Get this. Cooper's beating Randall 42-0 at halftime.
Cooper's?
Yeah.
Dang. I hope they, like, go to the state championship.
Yeah.
I'll go to that.
I might too, because I have a lot of friends. I go to a party on the team, too. Ben Marcinkowski, Nick Coppola.
Don't run out of bounds. Oh my god.
My name is Jonah, and I'm the most overrated player ever.
Yep.
My name's Jonah.
I like watching spooky things on Google Maps, so like when I go to check out, so I can look at it.
Girl, you need a hot boy. Girl, you need to stop fucking with them hot boy. Oh yeah, did you see her freaking midget? What a dad.
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot. Tech plays at 9:30.
Oh, I fumbled again. Right on the 2-yard line.
We're back.
Okay, Boomer. Okay, Boomer. Oh, shit, Boomer.
Was that your alarm?
Okay, Boomer.
Okay, Boom. Damn, what should I play? Red Dead Black Ops 4. Oh shit, my parents are about to be home.
Okay, Boone. Bro, why do my parents have to show up now? Probably gonna have to get off FaceTime because my mom's a bitch. Does a pillow work as a gun silencer? I watched weightlifting injuries yesterday and I about killed myself.
I like when they're like squatting and they're themselves. That's the funniest thing ever.
Who poop theirself during competition? Ugh, nasty ass nigga. Ooh, he was pooping it up. Oh, the center shit himself. Oh, I feel bad for the quarterback. No! Imagine! The center shits himself and the quarterback.
I would do shotgun formation.
Yeah.
It's like a dive play in you.
Nasty ass nigga.
It's a dive play and you run it out of shotgun.
You just take a head of shit, you take a ass of shit right in the face. There's shit all over your helmet. Are they ever gonna show freaking shit stains? That's all I wanna see is poop stains. Aaron Polka shits and peaks squatting 805. Oh, that's nasty if he shits. Yuck! It just fucking threw up everywhere. Fucking nasty. Hugo shits himself after stream.
I'm still a 3-star, oh my gosh.
Who's your number one option right now?
What?
Who's your number one option that wants you right now?
I'm about to find out. Houston gave me a scholarship. Oklahoma, LSU, and Texas A&M are looking at me. I'm gonna go with... Dude, I beat all of these schools. I'm going with LSU.
Romero poops himself during fight.
My number one option right now is either
Oh, he's got shit stains on the freaking octagon.
I got one more game left. The state championships. I'm only at 3-star.
And he goes on a win.
I was trying to become a
shit himself. And
I just started to make a shit.
Oh! This one's gonna show the intestines fall out.
No.
Oh my god, no way. No way. Ugh, dude, I might have to run if this happens. Oh, dude, he just threw up. Okay, that ain't that bad. Please don't shit yourself. Is this dude trying to elbow squat? Oh my god. That was funny, that video I sent you where they're like videoing the players on the field. And the dude's just freaking grinding.
Oh, yeah.
That's funny. Mitty's all like, Freaking Abernathy shit on for you, huh?
How bad?
62-14.
I hope they lose in the championship.
Nah, watch they rule the freaking quarterback ineligible, can't play in the state championship.
I hope they do that. I can't stand Bryson Bailey. Championship is a 29-yard pass.
You're playing in the state championship?
Yeah.
I'm trying to think about what I should do.
5-yard rush.
What now?
I feel like I did too much.
Let's get la-di-da. Get la-di-da.
I felt like it.
My bad. Okay. My bad. I'm tripping. My bad. Damn. Should I get John Ross though? No count. I'm just gonna go back to playing Earl Campbell. Too fun.
Eric Dickerson.
And Mutt?
Yeah.
I already have him. I don't have the 94 though. I'm working on getting the 94 for Barry Sanders. That gives me an idea, though. Eric Dickerson in franchise?
Oh, yeah, you did the neck roll, though.
Yeah. I'm gonna win a Super Bowl, though, first with Campbell. Before I do that.
Wait, are you still playing franchise?
I'm fixing to go back to playing it.
Oh, I hit the...
This guy put Julio Jones as a running back.
Okay, boomer. Okay, boomer. My ears flooded. Dude, I found a headset that I want. I want the freaking Astro A10. It's only like $50. Tech loses deny. I quit being a tech fan. I will put all my tech gear in a shoebox and I'll throw it out the freaking house.
You won't burn it, though.
I won't burn it, but I will freaking throw it out the house for sure.
Wait, who do they play?
Creighton.
Creighton?
Yeah.
Win.
They should. I'm gonna quit training. Fuck that. I can't believe they just played like shit, and then Jemias got hurt, and we really had no chance.
Like, is he hurt bad?
My dude couldn't move his freaking leg. I don't know if he'll play today or not. I hope he does. It'll show that he's fine. But honestly, if he doesn't need to play, there's no need in playing him.
Dude, it's 7-7 at the end of first quarter. Like, this is the first time, like, it's been tied.
I found Mahomes' brother's TikTok. He's so crazy. He's gay, for sure.
Yeah, he doesn't look strange.
I heard his voice. He talks so gay. He's always like freaking with his Mahomes' freaking girlfriend. He's like, I'm gonna be doing her nails today and her hair. I'm like, nigga, you gay? What, are you fucking gay?
Dude, I was watching the Oklahoma versus
Yeah.
There was like no defense played in that game.
I know. And Tech was down 42-20 at one point.
That's not related to playing with fire. He's so bad at
it. Who? Our team is just snake bit. Can't get a break. Our fucking defense is hurt. I swear they gave us a wet ball. Dude. Earl Campbell in the all white. Oh, look at this to me. Oh, look at this to me. I get all you know. Get off. Vander Esch just tried to freaking lay me out. I said, nope, sir. Oh, the Cowboys are ass, too. They need to fire freaking Jason Garrett. Stetson actually thinks I give a fuck about the Cowboys, though. Like I said, though, Tech loses tonight in basketball. I quit being a Tech fan. I'll throw my freaking Final Four shirt away and everything. Face. face mask. What's up, nigga? Yeah. I'm just gonna freak around and make a bunch of players and see if I like this. Make Eric. That's back to back face mask holes. Actually, I'm about to make Eric Dickerson right now. That'll be fun. I'll come back to Earl Campbell if I want to.
Dickerson.
I'll put him on the ramps as well. Oh, what if I could give my player goggles?
He probably plays way too much Madden for himself. He's like throwing sidearms. He's like, Brady, go look outside your window and tell me if it doesn't look freaking creepy outside.
I know all the fog.
Dude, like, this is the freaking type, like, freaking atmosphere. The whole world could get nuked. Except for us, and we wouldn't know it. It's freaking trip outside. Alright, I'm about to make Eric Dickerson, though. It's gonna be dope. How long do I get to do mine?
It's only 6 o'clock.
Dickerson, bro. But he looking like a god.
We're about to go up like 2 before halftime, or 2 touchdowns.
Only problem is I can't really match his helmet. I'm trying my best, though.
Select the team you want to join.
Yeah, I'll put him on the Rams.
Real ass bitch, give a fuck about a nigga.
Start your season with recommended settings. If you wish to change roles or adjust options, use the tiles on the left.
Real ass bitch, give a fuck about a nigga.
Big freaking ass.
Dickerson would be an elusive back. For sure.
So I crossed the pylon.
I hope I can use freaking number 3029. That kills everything if you can't use the right number. Dang, bro. I need the goggles, though. That just literally makes it, like... Please. Please! Please be number 29. No, there's no number 29, bro.
Wait, did they retire number? What the heck?
I don't know, so. What's next? What team do you want now? I'll do Vikings. Halfback. Please have number 29. No, they don't. No, nobody has number 29. That number may be retired all throughout football.
What?
Number 29 might be retired all throughout football. Who else should I create? I'm gonna try Emmett Smith. I've seen 22 though on freaking Cowboys.
Yeah,
there it is. Yeah, they have it. Alright, let's do it. Emmett Smith. There's really nothing much about him though. Emmett Smith. He didn't really wear any cool accessories. He just played football, homie. You know, Emmett Smith holds all the records and everything, but as many games as he played is, like, surreal.
Yeah.
You know Frank Gore's the third highest leading rusher ever?
Yeah,
that's freaking crazy. He's been playing for like 20 years as a running back. That's crazy.
This 15 years. Next year will be his 15th.
Emmett played at Florida in college.
Yeah.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. Rider. Okay, I'm pretty sure like Emmett was like 5'9 or something.
No, he was taller than that.
Dude, I don't know.
Dude, I'm 5'9.
Yeah, 5'9. You need to stop fucking with me, thighs, boy. He was a black boy, too. He was a pretty big, he was a bulky back. He had a belly on him, dude. Okay. He had a big ass for sure. Big thighs.
Okay. The Cardinals' uniforms are so bad. They look like something off of Earth. Like something from 2010.
Running around the field. You need a hot boy. Damn, you need to stop fucking with no thighs, boy. Alright, so I'm pretty sure he wore scut. Some kind of scut.
Shut.
Yeah, I wake up in the morning.
I got murder on my mind.
AK-47. Dick slips on my mind. I didn't even mean to shoot him.
Accidentally pulled the trigger.
Reloaded my pistol, cocked it back, and shot him twice. His body dropped down to the floor. He had teardrops in his eyes. Reloaded my pistol, caught it bad and shot him twice. Didn't even mean to shoot him. He just caught me by surprise. I reloaded my pistol, cocked it back and shot him twice.
What kind of face mask this boy had to... Do you know Emmitt Smith played for the Cardinals for a little while?
Did you know that Drew Brees played for the Chargers?
For a little while, yeah, I remember.
He liked me. Got traded. So he got to play for the following Cardinals.
These are such cool face masks. I think that's it. That's Emmett. The robot on the Scut Air Advantage. Scut Vengeance Pro. There's so many face masks for this. That's it. That's an Emmett right there. It's a little baby Emmett. It's a baby Emmett. Oh, dang. I can give him the dark visor. Oh, that's badass. Fuck it, I'll give him a visor. Just for the hell of it.
Would add orphan symbols on the visor.
Oh, yeah. They might do that next year. Because they all have to wear.
Yeah.
Run around the real. They all gotta have big ass pads though, for sure. Run around the tent. Baby, you dig? I can't loot for you, baby. You dig? My phone lagging though. Thing. Honestly, I just like making them to make them. Just to look at them. See if they match the deal. Number 9. How about you put that fucking phone down? It's cool, they give you like sit, throw around, kill. Didn't even mean to put him. That nigga just caught me by surprise. I reloaded my pistol, cocked it back, and shot him twice. Nigga dropped down to the floor. He had a teardrop in his eyes.
Oh my gosh, I fumbled.
Emmett wore spats while. Surprise.
I wish they could put my helmet face mask on Riddell. I have like the best like quarterback face mask.
We gotta put the Pintos on my guy though. For sure.
I ended my high school career as a 4-star.
Hey, look at my live stream. This is Emmett Smith. It's probably my least favorite, but oh well. I'm making Dion, bro. Let's see if I can get number 21. No, there's no 21. Oh, dude. I'm gonna make a Falcons Dion. Oh! Falcons Dion, though? Oh. They have a number 21, though. True font.
I signed with. I could go play for Baylor and I'll be a first string.
What would you be at Tech?
A second string. Texas, I would be a third string. If I went to walk on, I'd go to Oregon to be a second string, Michigan second string, Florida second string.
Ooh, dude, please tell me I can get number 21.
I can go to Auburn and be a first string. In Utah.
Aw, there's no 21. That sucks. That would have been cool. I want to try 49ers now. My mission is to make a freaking Deion Sanders.
Prime time. I might deal with, like,
yes! Freaking 49ers have to wait one. Yeah!
Oh, you could have been adopted.
Yeah, no, they don't have 21 though. That's what I was wanting to do. Freaking Falcons go so hard. Their throwback unis? Oh my god. Yes, they're so freaking clean. I can just see Dion with the freaking red do-rag, the red bandana do-rag.
I don't know where to go.
He went to school at Florida State, if I'm correct.
Yeah.
How about you put that fucking phone down? Oh, he was left-handed, wasn't he?
Screw it. I'll go to Texas Tech. Nate home.
Deion Sanders was left-handed. Let's look at his height and weight.
6'3". 6'1". 6'1".
198. Yep, perfect. 198 pounds.
Can we play SMU our first game? What I love about Texas Tech, they play the easiest, like, the first two games.
Yeah, dude, their preseason, basically, is the easiest games ever.
Like, they play SMU, then FCS school, and they go and play 17.
How about you put that fucking...
Then Kansas, Iowa State, West Virginia, 13 Oklahoma, Kansas State, Baylor, bye week 15.
That kind of look like Barry though. You ain't never gonna see his hair, so there's really no point in changing it. Dude, his bandana freaking do-rag though, it's so funny. Oh, dude, I love their freaking throwback uniforms. Oh my god. They're so dang clean. Ugh, looks like Tech's uniforms.
I won't get to play against X in the year because, like, I have to win the first three. I want to show off my skills, man.
Gotta go over here to Robot. Pretty sure that's what Dion rocked. Okay. Damn. A dark visor on D. I can create Randy Moss next. Face parts. You didn't have none. Neck pad, no. Dude, the freaking 80s pads were so huge. Long uniforms just make it look throwback automatically.
Wait, am I actually playing a... I think I'm actually playing in the practice.
That's actually a thing.
Oh my gosh. This is what I get for picking Tech. I throw like deep open pass and you drop.
Wouldn't it be nice?
Oh, yeah.
Ceron all around the tent. I'm gonna wear the freaking player exclusive. Player exclusive primaries.
Has Texas Tech had like a true black quarterback?
Yeah. Zebu Etheridge. Played at Estacada, and then here.
Like, he started?
Yeah. I think another one. Yeah, that's probably about it.
For a minute, like, Texas had three black quarterbacks, and then they had Shane Buechel.
They had that herd dude, didn't they?
They had that
Swoops. Yeah, Swoops.
He had one good game.
Oh, yeah, Notre Dame.
Yeah.
Deion Sanders the dude to wear Jordans, though.
What?
If anybody was to wear Jordans, Deion would be the man.
Yeah.
He doesn't really look like Deion, though. Like, you look at him, it doesn't look like him. Probably because there's no throwback. Alright, now I'm going to go to Randy Moss. Randy Moss on the Vikings, or who else did he play for?
He played Patriots, Vikings, Raiders.
For a very little time. Vikings are, he played for the Titans too. Vikings or Patriots? Vikings would go hard. That's where he started. Let's go find them. Hopefully they have number 84.
Joe Montana.
It's gonna be hard to make it look like him, though. Be a deep threat wide receiver for sure. Yeah, for sure. Deep threat. Okay. Are you kidding me? There's no number 84? Oh, is he number 84 or 81? No, he's 84. Randy Moss played for the 49ers, too. Yeah, he did. Oh, shit. What? Ooh. What? What, Earl?
Thank you.
Casey, get up. I'm trying to make Travis Okoye. That should be an easy one.
Right.
Stupid dog. Alright, dang. This is stupid. Actually, I haven't.
Since that football game is over, 2 o'clock.
Okay. Dog, you are just a mess.